rounds?
Yep.
At least with 5 rounds, it's like more legit than you get in the top 8.
You did 5 rounds?
Yeah, yeah, I did the 25.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Makes me actually kind of happy.
He's green and watched today.
Yeah!
Oh, wait, he's playing blue.
No, he's not.
So I don't really think about the Game & Watch matchup still, even though I lose to Blake every week.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know much about Game & Watch still. I think, for the most part, though, I would consider this Game & Watch wouldn't want to challenge Luigi too much today, because Luigi's most have so much
power. Do they even not prioritize the up air? Or is that, or excuse me, the neutral air? That, the one with
probably
the...
Probably not. They come out so much faster, so they probably actually compete with most numbers. Luigi's moves come out like really strong. And Game & Watch is neutral, it actually takes a lot of damage. And then, I think this would probably be in the Luigi's favor. I think Luigi's ground game is pretty evasive. I don't really see any way that Game & Watch should be able to catch up. Wow.
I think D-Man's been getting better though. I haven't actually played him in tournament for a long time. But I used to beat him every time, and I played him somewhat recently, and I think he beat me. So, I don't know if that's because he's getting better, but I'm getting worse. Yeah, but no matter how much Smash you understand, you probably don't understand Game & Watch. Because nobody knows anything about Game & Watch.
It's
also weird to commentate because I can't anticipate what he's gonna do next because I don't know what you do as a Game & Watch. All right, it's like Blake takes game one. Balake present. And also, so where do you counter pick Game & Watch to?
Probably Dreamland, ideally. Probably. I think Yoshi's would be pretty decent. But they just play Mario Kart. This is typically considered the most best stage. It goes around longer, has more stage than they actually know.
That's kind of a roundabout way to figure that he's supporting the troops, but I think he doesn't. I think it has nothing to do with anything. It is just to get people like us to talk about it.
I'd like to see that.
Like,
let's see J-Man wave that shell shield.
Never.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of weird.
Yeah, that's crazy. A neutral hit. I mean, at 165, sure it'll kill him, but.
Yeah,
you know, I play Samus, and I have a pretty good neutral air as a Samus main, but I don't think it out-prioritizes the little parachute. So when I play Blake, I always have a I've only beat Blake once or twice.
Yeah, I think a lot of time characters have to put out their forward air to stop it, or if they're close enough to the stage, they just kind of air dodge through it. Up and in, so you can grab the ledge.
Well, what I haven't figured out forget, is how to ledge guard Game Watch, because he always comes, it seems like he's coming up with his neutral air.
Yeah. Best way, like, for Luigi, I'd like refresh my invincibility, try to anticipate what she has done, and I try to, like, put out a back air. And since Luigi can be, whatever the character will be invincible all the time, even if the other own beat boss hits you, it'll only be your back air that can actually do the damage, so you'll have to penetrate if you can. So, like, Sheik would be much better, Fox would be back air, Samus would do, probably do better. Yeah, Marth would do down air. So, Luigi has a lead, he has a really good down air, so he's rising down air, rising Luigi down air. Probably don't even need to be a Flash is brilliant for a GP.
Flash is only that one. I mean, I'm sure he's having the same problem we are, but he's actually having to play a game once we just get to watch. You know?
It's kind of a ledge dash. It's kind of part of trying to ledge dash. You kind of have two in your pocket. So you come to an SD.
I did in the last game against you.
Yeah. If you have to be a reasonably consistent body, you're going to be a good one.
Are we gonna play game 3? Or is he gonna choke?
I think a grab, a down throw, some down air.
For G-Man?
For G-Man, he may get a grab.
See that? I don't know if G-Man needs to just do that down there like you're saying, but I've
been... I think back air is probably the reason why he just kind of, he guessed the timing. A lot of that is going to be
a good thing. Yeah, that's right.
The worst thing you can do though is drop the punish and get the center stage.
Because I can't really tell if he mains Game & Watch or not, because he always plays Game & Watch, but...
I think he mains Game & Watch and has a 5%.
I've played his Falco once or twice before, because he'll pull it out if I beat his Game & Watch, you know, in any given day, he'll bring out his Falco. But that makes me feel like he thinks his Falco is going to be better than his Game & Watch, which I don't know, because I haven't had enough experience playing either of them.
I think in certain instances, there's like this Falco out there. It's pretty much it. It's not even care. It's not even like magic dependent. It's not even the person dependent. It's just, you know, loveless.
I think you told me once he plays Game & Watch because it's just more fun. You know, it's just, it's different, but it's fun.
But if you're getting frustrated,
oh no!
I'm sure it's not.
That's a bad SD for D-Man.
Stuck is in the free mission right now.
Wow, off the top.
G-Man is getting really DI. It was kind of unexpected. I expected to shine, especially the fake.
Too soon. That's how it ends.
I almost got to the full swag.